Good morning, students. So now I'm taking the chapter Cell, the Unit of Life, and I think that you all very well know about cell because we have studied about it in 9th standard. So, but now it's an elaborated form. Now, first of all, I will introduce you what the cell is. According to modern form of cell theory, all organisms are composed of one or more cells, and the new cells develop from the pre-existing living cells by division. The organisms formed of single cells, just like amoeba, chlamydomonas, are called unicellular organisms. And the organisms consisting of many cells are known as multicellular organisms, just like man, a tree are examples of multicellular organisms. The number of cells in multicellular organism is correlated to the size of the body. For example, a newly born human body has 2 into 10 raised to our 12 cells, and the number of cells increases with age, and a 60 kg adult human being will be having 100 trillion cells. So basically, what the cell is? Cell is the fundamental structure and functional unit of all living organisms. So let us observe a unicellular organism, just like amoeba, under a microscope. We'll find that a single cell is capable of independent existence and performing all essential functions of life. In fact, all cells have certain structures in common to them to carry out all life processes, but differential distribution of organelles gives cell distinct characteristics. Now, why do the organisms have cells? So, in all living organisms, the metabolic reactions can occur only in delicately balanced environment, and that is different from any found in the non-living objects. So cells are the life supporting chambers which have such a special environment. A living cell keeps its chemical composition steady within its boundary. So this condition is called homeostasis. So what do you mean? So you all know who discovered cell. A non-living cell was discovered by Robert Hooke. Then a living cell was discovered by Anton van Leeuwenhoek, and he was a Dutch merchant and pursued microscopy as a hobby. So he first of all saw human sperm cells, bacteria, protozoans, red blood corpuscles from 1675 to 1680. So he called the swimming creatures animalcules. So next, as you all know, Robert Brown discovered the nucleus in an orchid root cell, and Purkinje gave the protoplasm. This all we have studied in the 9th standard. Then cell theory was given by M.J. Squiden and Theodore Schwann. So Theodore Schwann also told about plasma membrane. Apart from cell wall, all the cells are having plasma membrane, which is called selectively permeable membrane. So what does the cell theory states? The cell theory states that all living things are composed of minute units, which are called cells, which are the smallest entities that can be called living. A cell is a mass of protoplasm containing a nucleus and bounded by a cell membrane, and it's in many cases by a cell wall also. So third one is, all cells are basically alike in structure and metabolic activities. And then the functions of an organism as a whole is the result of the activities and interactions of the constituent cells. So this is all about cell theory, which was given by M.J. Squiden and Theodore Schwann. So we'll study about next slide. What are the different types of cells? In earlier classes, you have studied about cells. You have seen even the slides of onion peel and cheek cell. And so they are the basic differences between plants and animal cell. You all know that a plant cell is having a cell wall as the outer boundary. Just within it is a cell membrane. Whereas animal cells are having only plasma membrane. They are not having any cell wall. And the animal cells also contain non-membrane bound organelle called centriole, which helps in cell division. Animal cells are generally having vacuoles, which are many in number but smaller in size, whereas plant cells have a very large vacuole which is bounded by a membrane that is called tonoplast. So many more differences are there. Besides this, you all know what are prokaryotes and what are eukaryotes. Prokaryotes are the cells which are having only nucleoide, not bounded by proper nuclear membrane. Membrane bound organelles are absent, and ribosomes are of 70S type, and their size is very small. In spite of that, the eukaryotic cells are a little bit larger than prokaryotic cells, and they're having proper cell organelles bounded by membranes, and nucleus is also bounded by nuclear membrane, and they can have all the chloroplast, mitochondria bounded by membranes. So this is the concept which prokaryotes and eukaryotes, I think everyone knows. And now, besides the nucleus, eukaryote cells have other membrane-bound distinct structures called organelles, just like endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex, lysosomes, mitochondria, and prokaryote cells lack such membrane-bound organelles. So, cells differ greatly in size, shape, and activities. For example, mycoplasmas, the smallest cell, PPLO, are only 0.3 micrometer in length, while bacteria could be 3 to 5 micrometer. The largest isolated single cell is the egg of an ostrich. Among multicellular organism, human red blood cells are about 7 micrometer in diameter. Nerve cells are some of the longest cells, which may be up to 1 meter also. Cells vary greatly in size and shape. They may be disc-like, polygonal, columnar, and cuboidal, thread-like, or even irregular. The shape of cells may vary with the function they perform. So this is all about the different. This diagram shows different types of cells. This is showing a tracheid, and this is showing nerve cell, which are very large in size. It may go up to 1 meter. Columnar epithelial cells, and then mesophyll cells, which is showing. So this diagram is showing prokaryotic cells. In prokaryotic cells, they are represented by mostly bacteria, blue green algae, mycoplasma, and pleuropneumonia-like organisms. They are generally smaller and multiply more rapidly than the eukaryotic cells. They may vary greatly in shape and size. The four basic shapes of bacteria are bacillus, means rod-like, coccus, spherical, and vibrio, means coma-like, and spirillum, means spiral-like. The organization of prokaryotic cells is fundamentally similar, even though prokaryotes exhibit a wide variety of shapes and functions. So, prokaryotes have a cell wall surrounding the cell membrane. Fluid matrix filling the cell is the cytoplasm. There is no well-defined nucleus. Instead, there is a nucleoid is present. The genetic material is basically naked and not enveloped by nuclear membrane. In addition to genomic DNA, the single chromosome circular DNA which is present. One more bacteria are having small circular DNA inside the genomic DNA, and these are called plasmids. These are very important plasmids. You will study about these plasmids in biotechnology in later classes. The plasmid DNA confers certain unique phenotypic characteristics to such bacteria. Some resistant factors they provide. One such character is the resistance to antibiotics. In higher classes, in next class, 12th class, you will study about in biotechnology. You will learn about the use of plasmids, how can we use the plasmids in various forms. So, nuclear membrane is found in eukaryotes. No organelle like the ones in eukaryotes are found in prokaryotes, cells except for ribosomes. And ribosomes are also of 70S type. Prokaryotes have something unique in the form of inclusions. A specialized differentiated form of cell membrane called mesosome is the characteristic of prokaryotes. So the function of mesosome, which is in the form of extension of plasma membrane, and these may be in the form of vesicles, tubules, lamellae, they help in the cell wall formation and DNA replication and distribution to the bacterial daughter cells.